Around a year ago, DJI released the DJI Spark. At the time, this was their smallest drone they've made ever, and also one of their cheapest. You could control with your phone, using your hands, with the remote. At the time, this was revolutionary technology, just the sheer size of the drone, the price, and how consumer-friendly it truly was. Now it's 2018, and DJI has made quite a few more drones, so we're gonna look into if the DJI Spark is still worth it. All right, what is up guys, it's G Martin. For those who check out my videos regularly, welcome back. If you're new to the channel, then welcome. Today we're gonna be talking about the DJI Spark in 2018 and if it is still worth it. First thing we're gonna talk about is the battery life of the drone. Now advertised, it says it gets around 14 to 16 minutes, but I found you get more like 13 to 15 on a good day, and if it's windy, you get even less, somewhere around 11 to 13. Now I believe in the future they will improve on this if they come out with the version 2 of the DJI Spark, as it will make the battery life better, because that is one of the low downfalls of the drone, the battery life. I wish it was better, and so do a lot of people, but that's just gonna have to come in the future. Second, we're gonna talk about portability. Now this drone, straight up, is very small. It's one of the smallest ones they've made. Especially the time it came out, it was the smallest. Now it has the Mavic Air, which is a good competitor to it. It's around the same size, but it can fold up, which makes it even smaller. But this drone, it really is small. Like, you just have to hold it in your hand and you can just tell. It is insanely tiny. It is super portable. I mean, this is the carrying case of the drone, and it's super small. Like, do you see this? Like, I'll take the drone out just to show you. I mean, this thing is tiny. It is literally, it fits in the palm of my hand. That is how small it is. If you can see that, like, that is tiny. So like I said, the portability for this drone is very good. It could be better. A lot of people have talked about making a DJI Spark with legs that fold up. That would be insane. That would be a super tiny drone, but you never know. If that happens, that'll be pretty cool. Next, we're gonna look into the camera of the drone. It comes with a 1080p 30 frames a second camera that has gimbal capabilities to pan up and down, and it can rotate. So if the drone tilts like this, it'll stay with it. It cannot do this. We wish that would happen, as that would literally complete the drone when it comes to the camera. For what it comes with, it is very nice. The only time it gets a little juddery is if you're in sport mode and you try and make a quick turn, you can tell the camera will jut side to side. But when you're in normal mode, the camera, for the most part, works every single time. The drone comes with what's called a tripod mode, which slows down the speed of the drone, and it makes the camera movements much smoother. And when you're trying to get very smooth B-roll, or even just video clips for your film, this works perfectly. It goes super slow. All the shots are incredibly stable. They look amazing. I mean, I have no negatives to the tripod mode. It works fantastic. Next, we're gonna talk about the overall features of the drone. So it does come with, like I just said, the tripod. It has follow me mode. It has a bunch of quick shots, such as boomerang and rocket. It has normal mode. It has sport mode. It can take high res pictures. You can adjust everything with the camera. You can adjust white balance, ISO. I mean, everything truly. The shutter speed. You can take some amazing photos with this too. If you lower the shutter speed, it either goes to 1 second or 2 second, but if you lower it to that minimum point and you're at night, you can get some really cool shots of cars on roads, or you know, anything like that. Now we're gonna talk about the price of the drone. When I bought it, I paid $450 for the drone and the remote. I believe now it is $400 for the drone and the remote, which is a deal they have going on at DJI's website. And that is at the time of filming this video. If they still have it, it might be worth their time to go check it out. But for $400, this is the cheapest drone they have at the moment. Besides maybe if you find a used Phantom 3 standard, those are around the same price as that. You can only get that price from a used Phantom 3 standard. For $400, that is insane. The Mavic Air, I believe, is $800, and then the Mavic Platinum is around $1,200. Quote me if I'm wrong, it might be, you know, $1,000 even, but then, you know, it just goes up from there. The Phantom 4, the Inspire, you're going into the thousands at that point. So for $400, if you're getting into drone photography or videography, this is an amazing price, and I have no negatives about that. The price is really the selling point, honestly, because the drone does have a few faults here and there, but for $400, that's kind of expected, really. So price, 10 out of 10. I mean, that is, if you're getting into drone photography, I would highly recommend the Spark. for the price, the features it comes with for the price. I mean, nothing beats it, nothing. Ending thoughts on the Dren. You get a cheap Dren with a bunch of features. It can take nice videos and photos, comes with a bunch of quick shots, a bunch of nice features, and the overall size, portability, all that comes together to make one fantastic Dren worth looking into. This is gonna end off my DJI Spark review. Thank you for taking the time to watch it. And if you really liked what you saw, maybe go on DJI's website and check it out. You might want one for yourself. But yeah, I'm G Martin, and thanks for checking out my video. Make sure to leave a like, comment, subscribe, hit that notification bell if you haven't already, and I will catch you in the next one. So, peace.